disrupted the art world, questioning what art is or could be while proposing a new mode for its production. A propulsion of post-war pop sensibilities, a monumental painting depicts an American fighter jet firing on and destroying an enemy plane. Executed in the style of an enlarged cartoon, complete with word bubble in acrylic and oil on canvas, the work is a diptych, comprising of two equal-sized panels, each measuring 68 by 80 inches. Purchased by the Tate just 2 years after its execution, it is now a highlight of the Tate Modern Galleries in London. To create Wham, Lichtenstein took a single panel by the cartoonist Irv Novick from an issue of the DC Comics monthly All-American Men of War. He then sketched out the image and projected it much enlarged onto the canvas before tracing the outlines. Shading was created using Bende dots, colored points spaced and overlapped to create optical effects, named after the inventor of the process, the 19th century publisher Benjamin Day. Lichtenstein applied these dots of paint using homemade aluminium mesh and a scrubbing brush. The work also demonstrates his signature practice of using bold planes of flat color and heavy black outlines. Lichtenstein uses the cartoon as a starting point, but then transforms it, and not just in scale. He simplifies the composition, removing the pilot's speech and the whoosh of the missile. He also halves the canvas, filling the left panel with the American jet and the right panel with its target, creating a cause and effect of aggression and destruction. In the scene, the pilot's thoughts are neatly ballooned. I press the fire control, and ahead of me, rockets blaze through the sky. Punctuating the action is the onomatopoetic wham, which slams home the violence in an uncomfortably jocular and juvenile way. I was interested in anything I could use as a subject that was emotionally strong, usually love, war, or something that was highly charged, Lichtenstein remarked. Indeed, Wham could be seen as the counterpoint to his romance series, melodramatic pictures of distressed women and silent men. Others see the painting as a what-if reflection on the artist's military service in the late 1940s, during which he almost trained as a pilot. Lichtenstein was an unlikely maverick. He was a university professor long before he found success as an artist. Wham represents the artist at his most rebellious, creating a new artistic expression condemned by some as appropriation. Life magazine posed the question, is he the worst artist in America? Others championed him as a visionary. Andy Warhol envied his painting technique and his gallery sense. Organized perception is what art is all about, Lichtenstein claimed. Pop art looks out into the world. It appears to accept its environment, which is not good or bad, but different.
is like the house that I had a dream about. This kind of front porch. It's odd. That's why I remembered it. And it was a street like this that we walked down, and this is where the house party was at. I mean, not this particular house. I think it was also blue or gray in my dream, but it's what the front porch, and it came around to the front, not to the side, but it was kind of like that. It was built out from the second level door.
Microphone with Ross MG. All the people in the dance will agree that we're